All right, so let's get started making a promo teaser video. So this is hard. I have to look through a phone on a tripod and see what I'm doing. All right, so the first thing you're going to want to do, almost all of the videos I make, I use the app Splice. It is a GoPro app. You don't have to use a GoPro. I use my cell phone for 99% of the video I do. I only use my GoPro when we're like doing underwater footage. So that's one of the apps I use to make videos, which I'm going to be going over today. The other app I use is exclusive to iPhones, and it is called iMovie, and it should come with your iPhone for free. So let's go back to Splice. So when you open up Splice, you will have a log here of all of the videos that you have made, and you'll want to eventually delete them in order to make room for new videos. Videos take a lot of memory. I have way too many and I need to delete them. So just so you know, the way you would delete it is you would click on the actual project. Up here, click on, you can make a project name. This one was called 103. I've made over 103 that have not been deleted. And you can hit down here, delete project. I'm not going to delete it because I'm not sure, I might still need that one. I actually already did upload that one, so I could delete it. And that will save me memory. So delete project, delete, and that frees up space. All right, so to make a new video, the first thing you're going to do is hit the plus sign. Oh, did you see that? Let me hit cancel. It was right up here in this corner, plus sign. And before you start making the video, you have to pick out which pictures or which video clips you want to use. So you can search by all photos or all videos. So I switched it to all videos, and I'm going to show you how I made that Fashion Fix teaser video that I just made yesterday. Now, I already used my phone and took video clips. If you press down on it, it normally gives you a sample of what that video is about, but right now it's, I don't know, maybe it went to my iCloud or something, so it won't show it to me. But anyway, you click the videos that you want to add. I'm just gonna do 3, because if you do more, like 5 or 10 or 15, it might take 3 minutes to load, and I'm trying to do this quickly for you. So let's just say 3 video samples. I'm going to click on the right-hand corner, add. See, it's telling me I have low storage. I'm going to just say continue, go ahead. It's fine. I got to clean up my phone. So then the next option, the screen that pulls up, is going to ask you what music you want to add to it. I usually skip this and go back and add the music, because I noticed with the app, sometimes if you click on, let's just say, a category of music, and I'll show you what they look like. If you try to add the music, it's almost like it's too difficult or time consuming to add the song in the beginning, and it can maybe freeze the app and then it closes. So I always just go back and add it. So I hit skip for now. But just so you know, you do have an option to use songs that that the app GoPro Splice has provided for you, or you can click on iTunes and it'll pull up all of your songs that you have in your iTunes library. So you can use songs that other artists have made that you have downloaded. However, technically, you're not supposed to use those on Facebook. You don't own the rights to them. You can use them on YouTube as long as you write, like, this is a parody. I'm not using it to make money off this, you know, artist. I'm using it for maybe a background music for a family vacation, etc. So I'm going to hit cancel. I don't want to use any iTunes music, and I'm going to wait till later to add the music. So I hit skip. At this point here, you're going to decide if you want landscape. That means that the video will be viewed horizontally like this to fill the screen, or vertically. So I took the video in horizontal. I'm going to keep it on landscape. You can change the name of the project. I'm going to call this one FF for Fashion Fix. You can also from here decide if you want, if it's pictures. Like sometimes I do a picture slideshow showing all the pictures available, all the earrings. You know, I'll take 25 earrings available in our back office right now. and I will want a picture slideshow. At this point, you can decide if you want each photo to be shown for 4 seconds, 3 seconds, a quick 2 second teaser, etc. But we're gonna leave it at 3.5 for now. All right, so then that's done. So at 100%, it got all three of the videos that I want in my movie. Here's your movie timeline, okay? You can change the order. Let's say I wanted this Magnificent Musings to be the last one I show. I just push down on it and I can move it to the very end. I can move it to the front and drop it right there in the beginning. You can place it wherever you want it. Now from here, I usually like to add like a, I'm gonna call it a cover photo. So I'll hit that plus sign to add a new photo or video. You could do either one. And I'm gonna scroll down here and pick my picture. Add that to it. You can always add more pieces later. Now, one thing you'll notice is that they kind of automatically crop it for you, and they'll cut off the top and the bottom of pictures. In order to edit that, you hit edit photo, tap on it, and then see these two boxes down here? I don't know what that's called, picture within a picture. You click on that, and you literally pinch how small or big or where you want it to be on the screen. If you want to move it far to the left, let me show you real quick, you can put it to the left. And this is where it's going to end. It's going to start on the right and it's going to end on the left if I wanted to do it that way. So you can hit play and it'll show you how that picture will move across the screen. Most of the time I don't do that. Most of the time I try to fill the screen pretty much dead center and then kind of zoom in until the maximum part where it's not missing any letters. It's not cutting anything off. And then you hit play and you can see how it would look, how it kind of zooms in a little bit. So once you're done with that picture in picture, you can click go back arrow. And now that first picture is ready. It is set for 3 seconds. If I wanted it longer, let me just show you these features down here. I can hit time and I can move it for 5 seconds. I want everyone to have 5 seconds to see that cover photo. So now I will go back again. That is now set for 5 seconds. I've got my videos and maybe I want a conclusion. Here's another feature real quick. Yes, you can delete it, but also edit video. If I wanted to edit it, here's what you can do. I can crop it right here. I could say, ooh, I didn't like the beginning. I wanted it to start right here and I wanted it to end right here. You could just pick out that sample and it shows you how long, you know, where it starts and where it ends. The other thing you can do, which is really cool, is click on this little timeline down here. And you can make it go faster, like 1x7 faster if you were too slow. It kind of gets it a little like jumpy though if it's too fast. But you could do slow motion too if you were like, whoa, catch these details in slow motion. So at the, I think it's 1.0, one time, that's your regular normal time. You can also use that line in a box to zoom, not to zoom in, to add text if you wanted to add like the name of this piece, Santa, this isn't even Santa Fe. What is it? Glimpses of Malibu. I'm not going to type it all up because I'm like using my finger and stretching my neck to see. All right, so Malibu. You can change the font and you can shrink it or make it bigger and you can stick it in the bottom left corner. So now this whole video will play with Glimpses of Malibu in the back, you know, left corner, if that's where you want to put it. Maybe you want to type $5 a piece or $20 for the set. You can add text by clicking on that button. Now, the other thing you can do with video is this picture within a picture. If you zoomed out way too far when you took video, you can pinch in and now you're zoomed in when you play it. So it's not as far back, it starts off closer in. So you can decide like where, even if you wanted like black edges around the screen, you could, you know, this way that Malibu really pops. You could do it like that. So that's another feature. If like, see that, can you hear? It's like me making noises, breathing, maybe like the lawn guy outside. This little speaker down here allows you to take off all the noise. So your kids screaming in the background aren't in there. It's quiet now. You just move that all the way down to the, you know, no volume sign. You can also fade in a song, like have it come in quietly and then fade out if you want. I usually remove all volume. So once I go here and remove all volume from all three video, just in case you never know what's going on in the background. At this point now, I am ready to add my audio. So I click on audio. And you can actually add two different songs here. You can add like your voiceover, like when I do a parody and I sing, to sing and add audio, you actually hit that red dot and you hold down the whole time you're talking. So let me show you. Oh, it's gonna give you 3, 2, 1. You don't hold it down. Hello, I am gonna sing to this video tutorial. All right, so then you hit pause and then you can go back and you can actually hit play.
Hello, I am gonna sing to this video tutorial.
All right, so now if I like was trying to line that up to the beat of a music and it just was too early on, look how neat this is. I can drag that to start over here. All right, so now back here, it's time to enter our music. We're gonna hit that plus song. And from here, I like to pick a song that I don't think is a copyrighted song. If you go to classicals, you're gonna see like Pachelbel and Canon D, and this is obviously a copyrighted song. If you try to share this video to Facebook now, it's gonna flag it for, you know, music that you don't have the rights to. So I don't try to use songs that are gonna be getting me in trouble. So I'll go to like reggae, and you can hear a sample if you click on the little play. So this is like fun, like Caribbean mermaid-y type music. I use that one sometimes. I go down to ambient. This is like more soothing type song. So let's say you hear a sample. You're like, yes, that's what I'm looking for. You tap on it and it loads it and adds it to your video. So here you have that song added all the way to the video. And let me just pull my little voice over here so you can see how it would look. And to get the whole view, you hit this stretch it symbol and you can watch it from the beginning.
Hello, I am gonna sing to this video tutorial. All right, so then you hit.
Okay, so that gives you a great sample of how it works. Now, I really don't like that in there at all, so I'm just gonna hit, oh, let me show you how to do that. If you accidentally add audio and you don't want it, just tap on it, and in the upper right corner here, hit delete, and it's gone. If you don't like this Heaven Sent song, you can delete it as well. Let's say you actually want to combine two different songs. You can totally do that. I don't like Drugged. Let's look at Backstage. All right, so let me add that one, and now listen. So you can add like two different, oh, I just went back, so now it showed me all my videos. It's okay, it always saves the most recent changes you've made. So now you are ready to add this to your business page, to your shopping group, to YouTube, to Instagram, etc. You're ready to save it. You're gonna hit this download in a box with an arrow. And I have never actually shared it directly to YouTube, Facebook, or Instagram. I don't think that my app is even linked to those, but what I always click is save. And you have the option here to save like the smallest quality level all the way down to the highest. I always pick the highest quality level. It takes the most video memory space, but it's the highest quality. So then I'll tap that, and it might take a long time if it's a long video to save the whole thing. If you realize, wait, I made a mistake, I didn't mean to save it yet, you can always, you know, cancel the export. Now, I'm gonna see if I can actually get it to save and show you my next step. Come on. What I wanted to show you, especially team leaders, because I think it's really important that team leaders make these teaser trailers and promo videos for their teams to use to promote website sales on their websites. Once it has saved, it's successfully saved, what you can do at this point is go to your Messenger. I wouldn't send it through text, that compresses it and makes it smaller. You can go to Messenger and let me see, who can I send this to that will understand? Jody Fan. Okay, she's a sister in my team, so I'll just tell her this was a mock fake one. You click on this little picture button here, and it should pull up. Yep, my most recent thing that I saved. Now, once you send this to someone in your team, it's loading right now. There's a little white line going around. I'm going to show you how they can download it and have the highest quality available so that then they can share it on their groups as well. It's almost done. Bear with me. So most of the time, you see how like I made a little emoji face there? When you send a video to someone, if they... Did it send yet? Not yet. It's like almost there. If they want to save a copy of it, maybe it'll work. It's still sending. What you do is you hold down on like the corner of that video until it allows you to see like those emoji reactions. And once you have that option, you then can click on the bottom right-hand corner. I think it's down on this corner of the screen. It might be this side. You can hit save video, but I don't know why it's not sending. Okay, so it didn't show me the emoji reactions, but I can hit save. So I don't think it's sent though. It's still like white around the edges. That's a bummer. It didn't go through. But anyway, once they save it to their phone, then they can have the high quality version to share with their shopping groups and on their business pages as well. Whenever I make team videos, as I have posted samples to YouTube, I always do not add my information or my shopping group. Even here, you can see it says Mermaid Christine. This was for my Fashion Fix teaser. This was not something that I made for my team. So now it has sent, it's delivered, and I would click on this bottom corner, see the emojis, and it's actually on the right-hand corner. You would hit save. She's like, thank you so much. She thinks I'm sending it to her. I have to let her know I'm not. All right, so let me, she just loved it. All right, so save. I guess it already saved it maybe. Let me see. Yeah, look, see, I have it twice now. It's saved. So that is just as high a quality as this version, and that's what she will have now. So let me turn this off.